Hello, Victor Nygren here. I'm playing an unreleased version of Star Wars Total War for Rome Total War Alexander. It's an incomplete version. Dagovax has an even more recent version. I got this version yesterday on, I believe, Tuesday the 25th or something, 2020. But Dagovax has already added TIE bombers and an updated version of the AT-ST and an updated version of the TIE fighters to his version. Alright, and he has added LAF for Emperor Palpatine. Alright, let's start the battle then. We have four Empire armies, the Galactic Empire. As you can see, they are called Mordor or Isengard. That's because there were no expanded file, so I added the one from Lord of the Rings Total War in order to change the names. But I might change it to the vanilla one instead and then replace the names, so we can have the Galactic Empire and the Rebel Alliance here. Anyway, the first army has the Death Star. I am controlling this army. And then the second army consists of one Star Destroyer, and then they have five units of TIE fighters, the old TIE fighter. It's been replaced in Dagovax version. And then we have five units of AT-AT walkers. We have five units of the old AT-ST. It's still in his version, but he has another one that is more recent. And then we have the two units of Imperial Scouts on speeders, and we have two Stormtrooper units. Alright, the captain is also a Grand Admiral, and the Stormtroopers, they have First Order officers, commanders. Alright, this was the second army. And then we have another army led by Emperor Palpatine himself. We have a Red Guard unit as well. He has a bodyguard of Red Guards, but we have a unique unit consisting of Red Guards as well. We have four units of TIE Fighters, four units of AT-AT, and four units of AT-ST, three units of Imperial Scouts on speeders, and three units of Stormtroopers. And the final army consists of Darth Vader himself leading the army, and then there are I believe 10 units of Stormtroopers and 9 units of Imperial Scouts. As for the Rebels, they have fewer numbers of unique units currently. We don't want to use the old outdated units. So they have this army consists of the Millennium Falcon and lots of X-Wing fighters. They only have ships in this army to counter the Death Star. Alright, then we have another army with 5 units of X-Wings, 5 units of Rebel Marksmen, female snipers, but they are not snipers in the sense that they have sniper animations just yet. They are like any other infantry unit currently. And then we have 10 units of Rebel Troopers. Their third army has 4 units of X-Wing fighters, 6 units of the Rebel Marksmen, and 10 units of Rebel Troopers. Then the final army has 10 units of Rebel Marksmen and 10 units of Rebel Troopers. Let's start the battle. Start deployment. We will move the Death Star to the far back here, so it won't be in the battle from the beginning. Like that. Let's take a look at army or armies. We have the Imperial Scouts here. Really good looking unit. Unique sound and animations. Then we have the AT-AT Walkers. They also have unique sound and animations and projectiles. We have the old AT-ST mech unit. They are still in Dagovax version, but he has another one that is even more badass, more recent model. And then but these look more like the ones from episode 6. And then we have more of the AT-AT Walkers. We have the TIE fighters moving around using the jet fighter animations from Total War 1942. We have more AT-AT Walkers in this army. Then we have some Red Guards here, also used as the guard of Emperor Palpatine himself. Here we have Palpatine and the Grand Admiral as the captain. Palpatine is the officer. In the campaign he will be a hero unit, because this is the mod has been moved to Alexander, and in Alexander you can have heroes. Here we have stormtroopers with a commander unit, officer unit, consisting of a mix between, I believe, clone troopers and the First Order units. So, and it has, I believe, the stormtroopers have assault rifles, while the officer here has some kind of sniper rifle. Alright, we have more of the stormtroopers, we have more of the Imperial Scouts, the AT-AT and AT-ST mechanized units. And the final army consists of, I believe, 9 units of Imperial Scouts and 10 units of Empire soldiers. We are not using the huge settings, we are using medium size for the armies, because otherwise the Death Star and the Star Destroyer would become 3, and we don't want that. So that's why we are using medium size. In the campaign it would be possible to use huge size, because we can force the giant units to be 1 through the scripts, but in custom battle it's impossible in Rome to the War. They will always be at least 2. Same with Vader and such, if they aren't officers, if they were single man units. So you can see in the sky we have the Star Destroyer there. The animation didn't work too well with that unit because it's so big, but yeah, I added it anyway to the battle. It has the same projectile as the AT-AT Walkers, while the Death Star has its own uber powerful projectile. Alright. It's always a good idea to keep up. Start the battle, pause, because we want to take a look at the rebels now. So the rebels have these rebel marksmen, women with sniper rifles. They have the rebel troopers here from episode 4, A New Hope, and then they have the X-Wing fighters. They don't have the animation of the TIE fighters, because Dagovax reasoned that it's easier to click on them and easier to manage airships if they don't have that animation. So if you click on them to run, they will still move like that. And if you click on them to attack a unit, they will still circle around the unit. But otherwise they can also walk, which means they will move very slowly forward. And they can also stand still. Personally, I prefer the animations, but many players of Total War 1942 have said that they didn't like the animations of the ships because of the planes in that mod, because it's hard to click on them. You need to click on the shadow here, this little circle, and not the unit. and also they are, it's harder to manage the planes, but if you have them on like AI control like I do, it doesn't matter, and my opinion is that it looks better, more like in the movies, etc. But it's easier to like order them around and such if you have no animation making them move all the time. Alright, and then we have lots of rebel troopers here. Some rebel marksmen there, rebel troopers. And then we have the army consisting of only X-Wing fighters and the Millennium Falcon. They only have three unique units currently, the Rebel Alliance. Let's unpause the game and watch the battle. Yeah, I think it looks better when they move around like this. But it's harder to move, to actually click on them and move them. You see, they stand still like this and get stuck in each other, etc. So no, I think you should add the jet animations to these as well. It makes sense for the Star Destroyer and for the Millennium Falcon not to use the animation because they are too big for the animation, but the X-Wings and the TIE Bombers and similar smaller ships, they look way better when they move around. It makes the battlefield come alive in the sky, and otherwise they end up not moving like this most of the time. Here they are moving when they move from one point to another, but then they like stop moving when they are about to fire, and then they just stand still. So for reality purpose and for being more close to the movies, I'd suggest that he add the animation to the X-Wings and all the other ships as well. Otherwise it looks kind of meh. The enemy general is dead. Like this, you get them in, like they stand on each other and stuff. And also they mostly walk, they don't run, which means they fly very slowly from one point to another. Alright, if we take a look at the ground, we can see that the leader of allies has been slain. The walkers and infantry, they are actively fighting here, moving around. Stormtroopers, AT walkers. It was harder for Dagovax to do the four legs, but it looks kind of alright, I guess. It's hard to make four legs move at the same time. The AT-ST was easier because it had only two legs. Alright, there were a lot of infantry. The AT-ST is just walking over them. It's an elephant unit, so nice. TIE fighters are firing their lasers, green lasers. Fear makes a home in our enemies' hearts. Here the AT-ATs there. And the X-Wings. Yeah, it looks very meh when they just stand still. I know they are easier to click on, but if we want real Star Wars air battles, I think they need that animation, like the TIE fighters. Looks so much better. Alright, the infantry is still alive. They are currently firing at something. Maybe the ships. Wonder where the Empire soldiers are. The stormtroopers. Here we have some scouts. Imperial scouts. Ah, they are already routing here. They faced the wrong army. They faced the spaceships. That's why they are already beaten. These units would be better off using the sniper animation, as they have sniper rifles. It would make them very deadly. I know they aren't as easily seen if they lay on the ground, but yeah, it makes sense for snipers to lay on the ground. Otherwise, I think they looked great like this. Alright, and then we have the regular troopers here of the Rebel Alliance. Yeah, both the Galactic Empire and the Rebel Alliance will of course get more units, but especially the Rebel Alliance is in need of more units. The Empire will get snowtroopers, I believe, and maybe a unit consisting of Darth Vader's bodyguard, a sniper unit. And besides those, it's likely that they will get the Gamorrean pig guard of Jabba the Hutt and Jabba the Hutt himself. So they will be part of the Galactic Empire, and maybe a Mandalorian unit based on Boba Fett. So they might have Mandalorians flying around, and maybe a droid. Besides those, maybe the scout droid, the Reckon droid, but otherwise I think they will be pretty much finished. They might also get the TIE interceptor. It's a better fighter spaceship. So, but for the Rebel Alliance, they are in need of a lot of units. They only have 3 currently. They have at least a Twi'lek infantry unit, another human like Hoot infantry unit, and then they have of course Wookiees, and besides that maybe they have some Ewoks with bows and spears and javelins. Otherwise they need of course mechanized units, and I don't know if we have any mechanized units currently. As for the spaceships, they only had the Millennium Falcon and the X-Wings, but it's possible to get spaceships from elsewhere. I've downloaded some other spaceships for the Rebels from the internet, from fans, so maybe they could get one of those. As for the mechanized units, we could use maybe some Empire at War models, I don't know. Yeah, they are in need of a lot more units. And then we have the idea of maybe adding the Republic, the Trade Federation, and maybe the Confederacy of Intergalactic Systems, CIS. They don't have a lot of models for those factions. The Republic is easy because clone troopers are easy to get, but as for the droids etc, we have some droids, but we don't have enough for an entire faction. That's the problem, especially for the Confederacy. We only have the Count Dooku, I believe, and maybe one unit. Alright, we have all the heroes we could need, even from the sequel trilogy if you want that, but not enough mechanized units and ships. I believe the Death Star just fired unit here. Their general, one of their generals. He had four armies, each army has a captain. And that's one of the captains, still a vanilla unit. So the officers of the Rebel Alliance are still in need of mortals, but we have that as well.
The enemy general is slain, and now his men fear us. It is time to press
the statistics. 7% allies killed, and I'm playing the Empire. And 86% enemies killed, alright. Very equal battle, despite we having both the Star Destroyer and the Death Star. Death Star was far behind the rest of the Empire's forces, which means it didn't partake in the battle most of the time.
Enemy army is in flight.
And that's why the rebels probably got the upper hand, but now it's becoming more equal because, or we are leading because the Death Star is killing a lot of their troops when they get close to it. There, TIE fighter still in the air, 80-80 here. Here we had a lot of infantry troops still standing of the Rebel Alliance, troopers and some marksmen. Seems the Star Destroyer is still alive as well. Dagovax is going to remove the animation for it, and I agree with that because the big ships like the Star Destroyer or the Death Star, they aren't suitable for moving around. They just circle around all the time. It just doesn't work with that model. So for the big ships, I agree they should be they shouldn't move, and unless you click on them to move. Also, it will be smaller because we can hardly see it in this view, so he will make it smaller and closer to the ground. But currently he has the original, the huge Star Destroyer that is using the animations of the jet fighters that the TIE fighters are using. While it looks very good on the small spaceships, it looks very bad on big ones. Very good, actually. The smaller planes or ships. And really bad with the big one. Yeah.
The enemy show their true virtue. They are not soldiers, only frightened rabbits running from our men.
The Imperial scouts, they can run much faster than this. Now they are walking. If they start to run, they will move way faster. Let's continue the battle. As you can see, now they are running. But I don't have the sound. Very odd. A unique sound. No sound when they are moving. Let's see here, audio. That's weird. Have speech at 100%, special effects on 100%. Alright, that's odd. I will ask Dagovax why that might be. Because in his videos he has a unique sound when they move and such. I believe Palpatine didn't laugh either in this version. but he did in his video, so maybe I don't have the sound files for the units. The unique ones. I have the vanilla sound, of course. And the sound when they fire blasters. But not the sound when they move and laugh and such. I have the marching sound, so you can hear it. I don't have the blast sound of these guys though. I'm missing some sound files, I believe. So the rebels managed to take down a lot of the TIE fighters as well. Lots of dead stormtroopers here. Let's speed up the battle. It's over. And it's over. I can hardly read the statistics. Show battle statistics screen. Here it was easier in the details screen. That's good that we can read it here. The battle results are very hard to read. It's not impossible, but alright, we're done.